Well, hello there, Chosen. Welcome into the service of the gods. As I am a believer myself, I am happy to be the one to guide you. Theodore's the name, but little old me is not relevant here. You are. I am here to tell you of some basic rules and hand over any divine objects that may have been bestowed upon you. First and foremost, the cosmic seed. Yes, Thea is far from a land of prosperity. Darkness was defeated long ago, but it is not gone. It lurks in the corners and attacks at night. The shattering tears the earth asunder, and a scorching light takes hold of folk without protection. The seed, and others like it, is a gift of the divine, a piece of the cosmic tree itself. It can grant great boons, and it allows you to set up a village and provide divine protection there. But if you wish for the life of a traveler, or if you are skilled enough to create another seed one day, this seed can be used to forge divine artifacts, or even bring back a comrade from the clutches of death. Indeed, you catch on fast. Without the seed or different means that other factions may possess, a village attracts the cursed light and is taken by it within days. And if somehow that does not happen, terrors of darkness will drive your folk insane. This is how it has been in Thea for many centuries now. It is why we struggle still to survive just another day. I may pop up now and again to tell you things, but for now, you must take your first steps into this hostile land. Remember to check for resources on the map for gathering, set up camp for craft and cooking, and check your inventory to make sure you are well equipped. Here, have some wood, so you may heal when camping. My advice is to explore, learn the ropes, and only then decide on a settlement.
Thank you. Shaken in your sleep, you wake to find yourself fallen from a hammock onto dry, brittle soil. Dazed and displaced, your eyes glaze over a land steeped in dark shadows. There is no hammock, no sign of your camp, but there is a dim light flickering ahead. You walk towards the light, and with every step, the shadows part beneath your feet and a path is revealed. The path leads you to a lone island upon a sea of white sand. The island is only small enough to hold one tiny tree sapling, barely grown from the evergreen soil beneath its long silver roots, and yet its presence is overwhelming as it tugs at the very fabric of your being. Six stones lie before you, floating in the air. One is smooth and black, with a single rune glowing on it. One is rough, uncut, woven with green vine. One is made of red ruby and shaped into a heart. One is square and seems to have rows of words written upon it. One is sharp, hot and red with blood. One is made of glass that reflects a single ray of sunlight, even here. You know each stone speaks to the divine domains, and you know approaching them will guide you to your deity.
You hear the clutter of blades clashing, and you are blinded by three stars appearing before you.
My chosen! Yes, good. You felt the call of the beast, felt your blood rushing into combat, even as you sleep. Yes. Now you must be my sharpened spear amongst the lands of the living. The mark of the stars is not for cowards. You must stand strong in the face of any enemy, and you must kill them with honor or die trying. You must be my blade, for the land will soon shatter into oblivion.
You hear the voice of your god shift, as if they now spoke as all the gods together.
This is a sacred cosmic tree, our divine home and our duty. It holds darkness at bay, you see. The crown holds the dark skies where they should be. And while the dark lingers yet in our land, it is no longer all-devouring. And yet, the tree stands in peril once more. But more so, we all stand in despair. The gods fight with forces beyond your reach or understanding, but I believe the real fight awaits below, with you. Marked by the Pantheon, you and those who will join you will find the truth that is clouded from our divine sight. For the cosmic tree fell to the danger, and so did our divine parents Mokosh and Heron. And our eldest siblings, Morena and Veles. The four disappeared, and for a time the earth ceased to break. They also shielded the tree, but this has its own side effects. The tree is protected, but this protection takes strength from us directly, so we cannot give our full strength to our children. Once again, it is up to mortals and their allies to restore Thea. Marked by the Pantheon, you and those who will join you will find the truth that is clouded from our divine sight.
The voice of all gods speaks to you with sadness.
It is something old, something hidden, something that beckons me to its grasp. Fires burn ever brighter, the sun grows stronger, and yet it feels wrong. Our time here grows short. I know not what path you need to take, but I will guide your steps as you will guide my sight. Go, live, grow, but do not forget your purpose. One voice speaks to you today, but all the divine eyes are upon you, chosen. All of you who listen today are marked and watched by their divine guardians. The cosmic pantheon has many voices, but we are all one, lest we are all gone.
You will find signs. You will see the wrongs of this land. In time, your true purpose will become clear to you. Be well, our children.
Weary from your travels, you come across a small hamlet, and you are invited to rest and eat with the family. They also offer their stables as a place to camp if you need to. You get a warm meal and are invited to listen to folk tales from the old Baba. The children ask you many questions about the wider world, and you are somewhat relieved when it is time to sleep. Woken by a distant tremor, you rise from the gravel and dust that surrounds you. Mere steps away from you, a deep gash has swallowed the farmhouse that gave you refuge the night before. Dust and debris are all that remains. You search the debris for other survivors. There was a family of six. The little girl gave you her doll to keep you safe at night. There are no signs of life. In fact, you realize that it is very quiet and still here, as if time itself has halted. You look down the chasm to check for bodies, but instead of the darkness you expected, you are blinded by a ray of bright light. The light dims, and before you stands the family. Their bodies are twisted and broken from the shattering, but they seem unhindered by it, their eyes white and focused, yet empty. Their limbs are loose, unnaturally relaxed even. At first you assume they are now unliving, but you can see blood still pumping in their veins and their hearts beating slowly. They walk away from you without a word, moving together in unnerving unison. An oppressive emanation of light and order pushes against your very being. This light seeks to stifle any magic or darkness, and the order seeks to diminish all turmoil. Your bones twist and your blood boils from the assault. You defeat the family and see their bodies burn to ash as they fall. The oppressive light lingers, as if searching for a new host, but it does not approach you, and eventually it disappears.
You come to a place torn up by tremors. Surrounded by deep chasms in the ground lies a small patch of swamp. Within sits what looks like a very large toad perched on a water lily leaf. It croaks a sad melody. The creature turns to you and speaks, his voice surprisingly clear and melodic.
Oh, you see me. Oh no, but then maybe you could... A Chmu I am. I have no name, I think. Not that I can recall. Although now that you mention it, it seems like I should. Have you seen my swamp? I lost it. The earth shook, the holes came, and the swamp was gone. Then everyone left, only me, alone here. And I cannot stomp on dry land, you see. But I know someone who can help. Will you carry me to her? Great. It isn't far, only there. And because you were so kind, here. I hear my spit is good for healing and other stuff. The toad-like creature croaks and spits a green, smelly ball of goo and hands it to you. The Chmu directs you to an old straw hut sitting on a chicken leg, surrounded by low, hanging mist and the smell of baked cookies and burnt sugar.